you have to divide that decimal number successively by the required base, and whatever the remainders are generated, you have to concatenate all the remainders in the reverse form. So that ultimately will be give you the final resultant value in the generated in the desired base. And till what point you have to continue this process? Till the value of the quotient comes out to be as zero. At that point, as and when you get the value of quotient as zero, you have to stop the process. Like we have one example in front of you, given in front of you. This is a number having a base as 10. Means this is this corresponds to the case 2 of the conversion technique. Here you need to convert it to a binary form. Means the desired base, the desired number should be having a base as 2. So what you have to do, you have to keep the number in front of you. You have to start dividing the number by 2 successively till you get the value of the quotient as 0. We say either you stop the process, either you get the value of quotient as 0. Because here in the last, you will see that one step is missing. You can leave it at this point. Either you get the value of quotient as 1 or you get the value of quotient as 0. Means you could go ahead a step further at the end, and this 1 would have been placed at the again 1 whenever would be divided by 2. It would have generated the remainder as 0 and ultimately would have placed this 1 in the position of the remainder at the last position. So that could have done. Okay, so how you do have to divide? You have to divide in a simpler manner, as you divide in simple mathematics. When 13 divided by 2 will give the value of the remainder as 1, you have to keep the value of the remainder on right hand side, and whatever the value of the quotient is being generated, this 6 will be generated. 2 6 is always 12. It will give out the value of 1 as remainder, and this 6 that is termed as your quotient will be placed here. And ultimately, again, what you have to do, yes, please.
Ma'am, Sagar and Pranav, ma'am, Sagar ko admit kar dijiye.
Okay. So what we have to do, that we have to divide 13 by 2 successively till we get the value of the quotient as 0 or 1. Even if you get the 1, then also you can stop, but this stop the process, but this last value of the quotient will be used in that case as a part of your remainder. Ultimately, this 13 whenever will be divided by 2, it will give you the value of the quotient as 6, and then this further and value of the remainder as 1. Further when 6 will be divided by 2, it will give you the value of quotient as 3. You will be placing the quotient value of the quotient in this manner, and the whichever is the value of the remainder, in this case is the 0, will be kept on right hand side. And again you will be dividing this quotient by 2, and you will be getting the value of the remainder as 1, whereas you will be getting the value of the quotient as 1. Again the quotient as 1. Again, what by rule, what has to be done, then this 1 again needs to be divided by 2. You can add one more step here downside, and ultimately you will be getting the value of remainder as 1. You will be writing down remainder 1 on the right hand side, and you will be writing down the value of the quotient on downside. So this can be done, but you can leave this quotient as such as well, but this 1 ultimately may be used as the part of the final value if you are leaving it as such. So ultimately what you have to do, you have to reversely concatenate. So down arrow you need to put in this in order to show the direction. What you have to do, you have to reversely concatenate all these remainders in order to generate your final resultant value. So after reversely concatenating all these values of the remainder, like, then you have to start from the extreme right hand side. Means this, the at the first order, whichever value of the remainder was generated, that will become the least significant bit, and that will be kept on extreme right hand side. The next value will be kept on second position of the right hand side, and so on. Means reversely you are going to concatenate in order to get the final value. Now if you do, we do have a fractional value. This is our case. Like we do have a fractional value, such kind of the example we do have 0.625, or rather you may say that you do have a number as a इट मे बी 45.625. 45 मीन्स अ नंबर कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ द इंटीग्रल पार्ट एज वेल एज योर फ्रैक्शनल पार्ट. सो द इंटीग्रल पार्ट, सो फार एज द इंटीग्रल पार्ट इज कंसर्न्ड लाइक 45, यू विल बी डीलिंग इन अ से इट वुड हैव बीन 45, देन यू वुड बी डीलिंग इन अ सिमिलर मैनर. देन दैट 45 अगेन सक्सेसिवली वुड बी डिवाइडेड बाय द डिजायर्ड बेस. Desired base is 2, and ultimately whatever kind of the remainders would have been generated, you will have to concatenate all those remainders in a reversal order in order to get the final value. So this way you will be dealing with the integral value, but here in front of you do have only fractional value. So how to deal with the fractional value in order to convert the decimal number, the given decimal number, into a desired numbering system having a base as 2. What you have to do here, you have to successively multiply by the desired base as 2. You have to successively multiply it. So whatever after this number when got multiplied by 2, whatever the value it results in 1.25. So 1 you have to keep under the title as integer, and you have to keep the fractional value as 0.25 under this. Again you have to check the value of 0.25. It should be either equal to 0 or equivalent to 0, almost equal to 0. So as and when you have to repeat the process till you get the value of the fraction equal to 0, or even if the you don't have, sometimes if it is not a multiple of 2, always after multiplying by the 2, it is not always being generating the fractional value 0, but it should be extremely smallest value equivalent to the 0. Then at that point also you can stop the process. So you have to go on successively multiplying by in such a manner that 0.625 multiplied by 2, you will be getting 1.25, and 25.25 will be written here. And you have to keep aside this integral part in order to be used later on in the final result. Ye sare ke sare integers part aapke kahan use honge? Final resultant value mein use honge. But only jo fractional value generate hui hai, that is only for condition checking ki at which point you have to stop the process. A 0.25 is again, you need to be multiplied by 0.25 by 2. Only this fractional value, subsequently, you have to multiply it by 2. Whenever this 0.25 multiplied by 2, like 0.250, you can call it as 0 or 0.25 only, multiplied by 2, again, it will result into the value as 0.50. 0 will be treated as your integral value, and 0.50 will be treated as your fractional value. Again, we have to check whether its value is equal to 0 or not. No, it is not equal to 0. So what you have to do in the next step, again this 0.50 needs to be multiplied by 2, again it will result into the value 1.0 basically. So now you can check that as and when the fraction value comes out to be as 0, you can stop the process. And ultimately, now here in this case, you don't, in a forward direction, you have to concatenate all these values of the integers whichever are generated. In the previous case, whenever we were talking about the case 1, in that case, whatever the values, not case 1, case 2 rather, whenever we were talking about dealing with the integral part, successively you had divided the number and whatever kind of the remainders were generated in the reversal manner, you had concatenated all those remainders. But rather in this case, whatever the values are being generated, integral values, in a forward direction, you have to concatenate. You have to do remember this thing. So what will be the resultant value? It will be, because we are dealing with the fractional part, so entire value whichever has been generated will be kept at the position of the decimal point, after the decimal point, to the right hand side of the decimal point. So what will be the value? 0.101, having a base as 2. This is our desired base. So this is the way that we have to deal with the fractional value, other than dealing with your integral value. Regarding the case 2 was whenever we are having a number in a numbering system having a base as r, and it needs to be converted, having a base as 10, and it needs to be converted into a desired base as r. So what you have to do, you have to successively divide the number. So far as integral part is concerned, you have to successively divide the number by the desired base. Ultimately, whatever are the remainders got generated, that you have to reversely concatenate all these numbers in order to get the final integral value in the desired base. But if the same number is having some kind of the fractional part, then in order to deal with the fractional part, you have to successively divide that fractional part by the desired base, and whatever kind, and you have to keep aside all the integral values which are being generated to be used later on in the final result. And this fractional part again needs to be multiplied again successively by the desired base till the point till its value comes out to be as zero. At that point you have to stop the process. So this way you have to deal with the case 2 of convergent technique from one numbering system to another, from a numbering system decimal to the numbering desired base as R. And based on this, you do have one question in your back exercise as well. You have to solve the back exercise as well as a solved example is also given in. Like one more example is given. You are given a decimal number 41.6875 having a base as 10. Means it corresponds to the case 2. So it is consisting of both the parts. It is having the integer part as well as the fractional part. I told you the way to deal with the integral part. You have to successively divide this number, and you have whatever the kind of the values of the remainders you are getting, reversely you have to concatenate in order to get the resultant converted value corresponding to the having a in the desired way desired base corresponding to the integral decimal value. Okay. And this part 101001 corresponds to 41. This is in binary form, whereas the 41 is in decimal form. Now regarding dealing with this fractional part, again I told you that how to deal with it. You have to successively multiply this number till the point ultimately you get the value of the fraction as zero. You have to multiply it, and ultimately you will be getting 0.3750, and this one is generated as the integral part. And you have to keep it on one side later to be used later on as a part of your final result. Similarly, this resultant fractional value 0.3750 again needs to be multiplied by 2. Ultimately, we'll be getting 0.750, and again it will be multiplied by 2. You will be getting 1.5. This 0.5 again will be multiplied by 2. Ultimately, we'll be getting as 0. Means only fractional value. This needs to be multiplied by 2 and not the entire value. And whatever on left hand side are the integral values are being generated, that ultimately will become as the digits of your fractional part of the final number. So in the forward direction you have to concatenate 1011. It will become so the fractional part in your desired in the number having a desired base as 2. So ultimately this will be the final converted value in a base in a numbering system having a base as 2. So from decimal to yes, please.
Then what if we never get zero? Like if the fraction part ends with 3 or something like that?
Please repeat your question.
And what if we never get zero in the fraction part?
I told you that there may be the two cases. Either you would be able to get the value as zero, and sometimes means equivalent to zero. Whenever it is equivalent to zero, then also you can stop the process. Like if it would have been 0.3 in the resultant in place of 0.5. So again, you need to multiply 0.3 by 2, and you have to go on repeating the process till you get the same kind of the fractional value are consistently being generated, or the values whichever are being generated are equivalent to zero. At that point, you have to stop the process. You see what actually we are doing. We are going to generate the fractional value, and the more the number of digits we are going to obtain in the fractional part, it will be having more least significant. Okay, so it will be having no impact on the value of the magnitude. So after a finite number of steps, even you can stop the process. Are you getting it? Because afterwards, okay, whichever kind of the values, even if you are going to generate, that will not having that much impact on the magnitude of your resultant number. Clear? So that's it about your case 2. Now we need to come to the next topic.